Hello everyone, welcome internet, welcome world, welcome assembly, or people watching the assembly stream, because, you know, things are going on in the world and we sadly cannot be in Helsinki these days, so therefore we are doing all of this remotely. So am I, so sadly no Mesukeskus for me, or nothing on any hills, or driving around with a Wii card on the tram system going from downtown to the Pasila station and back. So no, we are here in our little corner in a heat wave in an air-conditioned space. Yay for that. In Belgium. We are going to have an online assembly of some sorts, and this is part of it. What is this? What is, you know, the things around me? I am an arrogant bastard. Somewhat would call me a Belgialine and Olut Patrona. But we run every week on Sunday a thing on Twitch called Chips and Bricks, where we play live demos from demo parties releases going up to 20, 30 years back. And that's what we're going to do today. Not specifically on assembly. Others can tell history much better than we can with all the more different hardware platforms. But no, we are going to do Amiga stuff, because Amiga is still better than everything by far. And a PC sucks and Atari sucks and all the rest of you are lamers. So no, it's Amiga only, because that's what you do. So in case you're not familiar with us, what do we have? I have a camera here in front of me. I have some buttons all around me, which I will have to push every now and then and look into one of my other screens, which are plastered around me to control all of this. But what's going to be important for you is, here is me. I have here hooked up an Amiga 600 with some fast RAM and some extra chip RAM, but it's on the default CPU, 68000. It was also our friend Mr. Screen. Mr. Screen will allow us to see what's happening on the track loading, because we will have some loading times today. And this is live, we do not edit it. So what are we going to do? We are going to have a look at the Amiga Fruit Wars, or maybe vegetables, but fruits, that never really was. It was melon versus lemon, and if you mix them up, that's perfectly fine that it happens. That's kind of intentional. People made a big deal about it. I didn't know what it did, but in the end, we got some excellent demos and intros from all over the place. So we're going to do this chronologically. We're going to start from the far past to the not so far away past, which is called, like, you know, a few years ago maybe. Plenty of stuff to go through. We have about 18 demos and intros lined up here in this show, hopping down between melons and lemons. We're gonna start in 1992. As such, Melon Design was Amiga group, and what they were doing mostly, they were making intros for Crystal, a cracking group, and they got pretty good at it. There was a good design, wanted to make some demos as well. And by the way, I think they came from Cortex, another cracking group. Doesn't really matter, they wanted to make some cool stuff, and they absolutely did lovely intros. Go to your storage of disk images to have a look at them. We might play some later, you'll see. But yes, Melon came onto the scene really with their first big demo in 1992, end of March, at an event called the TRSI Easter Conference, held in Leuven, Belgium, which happened to be my hometown. So I was kind of there when this demo was released. And yeah, it came in with a bang. It's still considered a classic, and we're going to check it out, obviously, and go from there. So we shall now go to our Amiga 600. We will allow Mr. Display so you can follow the track loading. Pop in the disk and take it from there.
Thank you.
So that was Human talking about Melon design. They mentioned the hidden part. Let's see if I still remember how to get there. So I'm gonna reboot the 600. Just left or right mouse button at the startup. Let's see if it still wants to do it. If not, I'm gonna try it once and I'm just gonna skip it. But you never know. Well, this is left mouse button. I don't think that's doing anything. And if not, then I'll... Oh no, look, here we are. The hidden part. Enjoy. So yes, there's a hidden part. Many demos have hidden parts, by the way. Quick hint, if you want to get to them, try left or right mouse button while booting. In the meantime, we're gonna get onto the next one because, oh, it's not Human Target. This one, disc number two. At the Party 92 in Denmark, basically Melon came back with one of, is considered the best intros which are ever made out there. You already saw the Game Boy here, which, and of course, who says original Game Boy says Tetris, and then they made the Tetris intro for Crystal, which is by far one of the best intros that they've made ever. Let's check it out. That was it. Cool. That's good. Hello, hiya, I'm back again. In the meantime, we're gonna get the next one loaded up, because if I remember correctly, this takes quite a long time to load, about a minute. So yeah, what was the Crystal, we're still releasing things under the Melon label and vice versa. So this was 1992, excellent music by TDK or Mark Knight, and what you see here is really some kind of design that that woke up in the in their releases, which was really cool. Next one up is Boo, also excellent design, and if you read the text, you will see the mentioning of a other group, not Melon, but Lemon. So this is where they came up. We'll get back to Lemon, or Lemon Point, as you have to pronounce it actually, in, well, basically after this one or the next one. We'll get there. Let's get the Amiga back now. Loading time is ridiculous, I know.
Let's roll it. Let's roll it. Sä ajatus sydämen lämpenemään, että poika on maani mainion tää. Missä ihminen kaikkein kalleinta on, mitä maassa on ajatus sydämen lämpenemään, että poika on maa, niin mainion tää. Missä ihminen kaikkein kalleinta on, mitä maassa on alla Let's roll it. Let's roll it. Sä ajatus sydämen lämpenemään, että poika on maa, niin mainion tää. Missä ihminen kaikkein kalleinta on, mitä maassa on alla auringon.
And this goes on. Oh yeah, this is the first mention of Lemon, but before we head to the Lemon stuff there, I want to throw in one crack throw because of its simplicity that they did, and well, that Melon did anyway. It features a well-known Commodore 64 tune, extra bonus points if you can guess which one. Throw it in the comments of the stream or open your window and yell out pretty loud, so we'll get the message over. Also, that blue bar wasn't there with the ball when we did the final test, so yes, we're doing everything live, and if it bugs, it bugs. Not sorry. Thank you. That's a crack intro, obviously. I'm a bit loud. So, yeah. Many of these crack intros were made by Melon over, well, a year, 2 years. And what we're going to show you now is the first one from Lemon, or Lemon Point. We cannot show the first one because this is a family channel, and there are some pictures in there that wouldn't go all too well on all the streaming services, so we're not going to have them. So we're going to go with their first, let's call it a big win on a demo party. This wasn't an intro by Melon that won first place in intro competition, Amiga intro competition, obviously, at the Gathering in 1993. Also, coming back to the Tetris intro, see, back in the 90s, early 90s, ray tracing was a thing, as ray marching is now. Things haven't really changed, you just have bigger, well, first of all, balls, unless they're touching, but also a bitter, blah blah blah, bigger memory buses, data buses, and everything, but in the end you're still ray tracing or ray marching. Times haven't really changed. Let's head up to the first Lemon Point production of the show, their intro for The Gathering 93. So, yeah, Point, Lemon Point, different style altogether, very lovely, very calm, I'll stare at the black screen, let's get the next one loaded up. So, I'll do some more background on Lemon later after this one, because staring at the black screen is a bit stupid. So this is like the first of their bigger demos that we're gonna include now. We're gonna skip some stuff, I'll get back to that. So first now coming up is Rinky Dink by Lemon, another, well, without a classic, not as well known outside of like the core Demoscene and the core Amiga guys. That's why we're playing this, and you get to look at it. Wonderful graphics by Facet, or Facet if you want to do it in Dutch. I have right now nothing more to say, just check this very, very awesome demo. Yes, when there was were no internet forward to scream on, you screamed in your text at the end of your demo, and you put your messages over there. Let's lower this a bit. So yeah, but say, okay, we're going, Mr. Bastard, we're going chronologically. You have skipped a demo. Yes, we have. Actually, we've skipped a few, to be honest. But how one that we did skip was from Melon Design, was how to skin a cat. Why? It doesn't work on this setup. Amiga 600, 2 megabytes of chip memory, 8 megabytes of fast memory, and a 68,000. The bugger just will not run, and I am really not going to take out for one demo or the memory expansions on the 600. By the way, for you not knowing Amiga stuff all that well, the fast RAM is clipped on top of the CPU because it's not on the bus or whatever, because basically Commodore, whatever. So yeah, and I don't want to run it from a video because we're only doing it from real hardware here. So yeah, how to skin a cat? I'm sorry, we're not gonna put that in here. Also, sadly, because and then we would have a very long segment. We would could wait for the hidden part, which is basically for if you have the demo somewhere, just leave it running at the end, wait for a few minutes, and I mean 5 to 10 even more, and then you get a hidden part. Now, coming back here to Rinkadink and Melon Point, if you have noticed in the credits, many of the people who founded Melon came from Anarchy, who on their own did lots of cool demos in the years before that. And also what we see here in well, in the previous one, the gathering intro, was that there's a split from basically the cracking groups to like the real pure demo groups, so stop cracking games, you're killing the Amiga. Well, Commodore was quite capable of doing that for themselves, but yeah, that's the mindset that was still happening in the, in 93. You would have the release of the AGA machines, the 1200 and the 4000 would come on the market. Would have been really soon. You would have come still have the CD32 come out. Of course, nothing in stock for Christmas because thank you, Commodore. But there are many other guys on the internet who have talked and discussed this. I am not going to repeat that. I'm just an opinionated, arrogant bastard, as you all know. So yeah, that was Rinkadink. Next up is I think it's more of an intro. And if you know any Dutch, that always helps. Let's put the disc in. Okay, Rinkadink goes out. Lemon goes in. Let's put hello, Mr. Screen, not Mr. Display. It was renamed to Mr. Screen. So let's get gratis up and running. Gratis, gratis. It's in Dutch. The Oldskool is in Dutch. Everything is in Dutch except for some addresses. Let's intro. Ja, facet van Lemon is wereldleider van Lemon en dat vindt Bill Clinton en Boris Yeltsin belachelijk lekker. Ja. I have no idea if anyone on YouTube will subtitle all of this, but yeah. So, oh, I pressing left mouse button every now and then to go to the next address screen. This is suddenly, this has become an interactive production. So yeah, this was gratis. I just threw it in there because it, I could actually read the scroll text. It's good that finally doing with chips and bricks on the Nordics parties, like text and screens in Norwegian and Swedish and Danish, and suddenly is something in more or less my native language, so I can read this, which was like a bit of a relief. Like, yeah, international demo scene and everything, it's not always in English, which is perfectly fine. We're gonna continue with more Lemon, and I think this also has a bit of a loading time with, if I'm correct, a pretty cool initial picture. So I'll remove this box here for a second, so you can have a look at it, because it also has a quite of a long loading time. Specifically, I think it detects the memory in this machine and just loads everything into memory for once to save on loading. I don't know, some demos can do that, some don't. For instance, why Hardwired will not run on this setup, because it loads too much into memory. I think it doesn't like so much fast RAM. I'm blabbling. I have to fill a minute of loading time here. I'm just gonna shut up so you can check the picture. We'll be right back. That was Groovy by Lemon Point. We're gonna throw in another Melon design again. This is by now, and we're like, you know, in late 93, so we're all in a pretty condensed 18-month period here from the start of. It was Melon's demos got a bit weird for me. If you like it, then it's cool, and it would go on until when they did their later AGA demos. So this is another one that we've thrown in now, and it's Mind Expanding that will come up. But first of all, if you like or honestly dislike this, what we're doing here on our Chips and Bricks show, channel, whatever, that we're doing, looking at hardware Demoscene releases played on real hardware live. So we have Amiga C64, we're gonna add Atari VCS, Atari 8-bit later, we also have a Dreamcast and PlayStations around that we should plug in there every now and then, but haven't gotten to yet. So if you want to do more of this, we have a website and a chips and bricks.eu where you can find our Twitch stream or twitch.tv/chipsandbricks, our YouTube channel. We have a Facebook page because you have to do social media these days. We don't do Twitter and Instagram because that's too much, and we don't like to be pressured because we're arrogant and we do things the way at the speed we want. But yeah, if just, you know, follow us, like, subscribe, throw praise, send beer to beer seminars, come and say hi at the parties of what we're doing, if you like this. So that's chipsandbricks.eu or twitch.tv/chipsandbricks. In the meantime, let's go back here. Melon, Mind Expanding. And let's go to Mr. Display and get you up and running. Hello, my hat is just, yes. This is Shadow in Hand. We're doing this live, absolutely. Clunk. Okay, I'm back to the Amiga. Reset and load up the next demo of the show. Hope you're enjoying it. And, you know, welcome to our virtual online assembly. Stay in touch. Amiga. Amiga. So yeah, this is it. It says it's Mind Expanding and nothing happens. And okay, sure. But then when you click the left mouse button, you get this, and then okay, fine, this flashes and that's it. But you know what you have to do is you have to hold the left mouse button, and then you get that. We'll be right back. And yes, that's me holding down the left mouse button all the way. If you let go, it just goes back to this. And it restarts. Okay, cool concept, pretty unique. But yeah, so in the meantime here, what happened was in 93, Lemon released a Dotro, which kind of was their last release. And also, I couldn't find a working file to run on this machine, so sadly we cannot include it. So we're gonna skip that one as well. So, you know, we're even, you know, we have skipped a Melon and a Lemon, so you can't complain. We've skipped one of each that don't work. So in the meantime, as we said, Melon was always like part of Crystal, and they were not, and then suddenly, you know, as cracking groups come and go, Crystal went, and that's why suddenly Lemon became Melon. I knew I was going to switch them up. They became For Rent, and then they made this. So yes, if you needed a crack intro down, you could rent Melon Design and do stuff. Up next is the last one from Melon Design that we're going to put into this show for various reasons. And it's the Boo number 2, second one. It's a 40 second load. So I'm going to already reset the 600 here while we do that. Or if you just want to have Mr. Screen, and then, you know, you can look at the loading tracks. But I'll keep an eye on it for you, and when it's done, we are going to switch back. So yeah, this is, as you can see, Kickstart 1.4. It's a soft kick Kickstart image, because most of the Melon Design things will not run on the Kickstart 2.5, I say this. We have to by software load in a different Kickstart in order to get everything to run. I think it's gonna be done now slowly. Let's go back to Mr. Screen, and then we're gonna check Boo 2. Here we are. Oh, look, it sprang.
As usual, I would request you, my friends, to refrain or stop from smoking while the program is on.
Well, that was Boo 2. Let's get the volume okay. So yeah, we have now ended up in September 94, which was already more or less a year after Lemon Point fizzled out. And you could say that's it. And most of it, that was Melon Design did do some AGA intros and demos, which honestly, first of all, we don't have an AGA machine available yet. It's being recapped, because if you get an old Amiga, you should recap it or it'll just kill itself. So get that done if you have one, by the way. They're not the AGA, and also they're not that good. And you know, we get to decide what we show anyway. So what happened now is that everything kind of went offline for 15 years, and offline being not so productive. And then suddenly what already happened on the Commodore 64 was that you had like good cross-platform development tools and emulators also started to happen for the Amiga. So suddenly you had a cross-platform development possible for Amiga computers, and people kind of rediscovered the Amiga 500 and therefore the 600. And because of demo parties getting all their old school compos together, you would always have like the Commodore 64 compo, and then you would have the Amiga compo, and you have the PC compo and the Wild compo. Many of the parties started to combine their old school and Wild demos, basically getting all the crazy stuff from Wild or animation even into the old school compo. And of course, and it was a kind of an old school revival. And although Amiga compos were still separate, which is perfectly fine, and they actually should be, for the record, it kind of went along the wave. And you know, we've just now have been in 94, and what we're gonna do now is we're gonna jump forward 19 years and end up at revision, because you know, this was assembly's been going on for a while, that it has basically encompassed and survived post the Mecha Symposium parties. It did Breakpoint, it did Revision, and it's still going. And so, you know, for that assembly, totally awesome for keeping it kicking and going for so many years, by the way. Really bloody deserved. So, no, what we do now is we end up in 2013. Because, you know, earlier on in the show, we had one of the first bigger demos from Lemon Point was Rinkedink, and then they made a remix version, so you will, which was released at Revision, and that's what we're gonna look at now. Let's get the Amiga back in here. Oh, it exited nicely. That's unexpected. And put the audio back on for our OCS ECS machine, and it's loading. See, suddenly it's you will see an entire design change influenced by, you know, some PC demos. You will have storytelling and stuff, but we'll get to that later. First of all, we're gonna check Rinkedink Redux. We'll be right back. And that was Rinkadink Remarks. Heat Ducks, hello. Let's continue the greetings and the designs in there also. You know, little heart to Melon design over there, by the way. So all in good competition after 20 years. And what we're going to do now is have a bit more of the recent Amiga demos and stuff. And it's continuing. Shall we go back for a second? Yeah, let's go back for a second, because why not? And there we are, Rinkadink Redux. Look back at the original, which we've played about 20-25 minutes ago. Some effects redone, others upgraded, some stuff added. Completely fine classic, redone in an extremely nice way here. And this kind of started the rejuvenation of all the older Amiga style demos on OCS. You see, they bow to the Rock Lobster. Rock Lobster, by the way, is the internal code name for the Amiga 500. This, by the way, the 600, that's Junebug, if I'm not afraid. Every Amiga had an internal code name. So yeah, this was Rinkadink Redux, and then it took about a bit of a year that we're jumping ahead now to September 2014 for the next production, Natsu no Gomu, if I pronounce it correctly. Why aren't you changing the... Now is the correct disk. Because it just restarted Rinkadink Redux, which is perfectly fine, but it shouldn't. So, yeah. And, smaller thingy, no track loading. Still, it's Amiga. Let's go. We'll be right back. Yeah, rubber vectors were a thing in the late 80s, early 90s, and they haven't aged at all. Still cool when you're doing them at the correct rate. This is a very cool thing to do. Going from a cube to a rubber cube, then you have a lens vector cube, but then you have all kinds of cubes. This looks really cool, really. Blast from the Past is next. Do I have anything more to say about it? No, not really. 2017, April, Easter time release. Let's load that up. I'll come back with more blah blah after this one. And that's the end of this one. from the past. Really, really nice. All the little zoomy bars at the front, graphics work really cool. And yeah, it kind of shows now that there's more time that people can make into putting these demos together. There is no more stress of being the fastest and the best and whatever. All the it's more kind of, you know, let's just hang out and watch demos together. We're all getting old, obviously, which kind of shows. And it's not, don't have to take it all that serious anymore. Like you're happy that you have a release, and you go with that. Up next is the Fall final version, by the way, a two-disc demo, if I'm correct. This is from another year later, April 2018. We're doing an Easter theme here, I guess, for the bigger Amiga OCS demos. Oh. Dark gray, hardware okay, light gray, software okay, widescreen okay, and let's boot. And this is loading. This is The Fall by Lemon Point.
Thank you.
So this was the fall by Lemon Point and the Deadliners. You will see this kind of cooperations more in the recent years as competition is getting really friendly, and you want to make a demo, you want to make a nice demo, and you get together from various groups, you make groups left and right, up and down, you do cooperations, although Lemon Point and the Deadliners will work together on multiple occasions, and this was absolutely one of them. What you would also see is the some kind of a storyline or a team coming into demos. It is not just one effect after the other when showing off with world records, although, you know, world records are still a good thing to do, but it's not about records, it's about doing it. It's about the journey. That was very 2020, because we're not going anywhere soon anyway. So yeah, zap the QR code, by the way. So yeah, we have two more to go. Next one is Lemonade, which is a shorter demo again, and then we will end one with another two disker. But we're gonna go first here with Lemonade, released in, let's have a look, October of 2018. Here I am. Well, that was short. Let me put myself here and a bit bigger in the screen. So yeah, this was Lemonade, and I have to say, with that the pink cube and then the lemon logo coming down on it, or was it the cube or was it a cylinder, who cares, we basically have come full circle, because remember in Human Target when that Melon design logo dropped on that cube in the hall, that was unseen, and the place exploded, and we have made a complete perfect loop from Melon design dropping the logo onto a cube to Lemon Point dropping the logo on a cube, and of course some inspiration must have been there left or right. That's without a doubt. Last one coming up here for this demo show, two discs, and this one is De Profundis, released April 2019. We are gonna come back after this for some more messages in the meantime. Okay, cool, here's the Amiga and here is Mr. Screen, and now we can load this up.
Thank you.
That was De Profundis by Lemon Point, Deadliners, and Oxygen. However you would prefer to pronounce this, so while we leave the credits running. So yeah, this was the last demo from the show here. We have jumped from basically Easter 1992 up to Easter 2019. That's over 25 years of, not all Easter demos, but over 20 years of Amiga demo scenes just from two groups. And when you look at, you know, we announced this as the war that really never was, because when you look at Melon Design and Lemon Point coexisting, you're more or less a year than you're in 1993. And so yeah, there was some you know, if you look at the first comments in Boo, first one, then yeah, that's like, well, why do you go for our iconography, why do you go for our name and stuff like that. Wasn't really much else. Now if you have to ask the question who of these won the war, well, first of all, there wasn't one. In addition, because they did many crack intros, I think Melon Design will be remembered for like doing the most stuff and being the most visible. Also, when you have like with Human Target and then the Tetris intro, early productions, by the way, they have left a big mark on the Amiga 500 OCS. You know, was only OCS back then. From AGA 1200 4000 was nothing. Wasn't even in the pipeline. So it's Melon Design for me will be remembered for the most bombastic demos and the big thing with, you know, as a bit Human Target. But when you look back at the current thing and actually making the best demos and the best work, is you're gonna end up with Lemon Point. So I think for now is what I would need to say to a Melon design and its former members, come back and please do something and throw something in there. I would love to have a demo competition somewhere, please, revision, please, where we would have Melon design and Lemon Point in the actual same competition. So yeah, that being said, about us, well, we are doing Chips and Bricks. We are doing this every week. Let's just cut the Amiga sound here for a second. We are doing this every week on Sunday. We go live and we play demos and intros from Demoscene stuff over the last 20, 30 years from real hardware. So that's Amiga, C64 mostly, some other platforms if we feel like it. Chipsandbricks.eu is our main website with links to our YouTube and Facebook pages, also to Twitch. Also, and for Twitch it's easier, twitch.tv/chipsandbricks. If you could, you know, do the follow, the subscribes, the notification bells, whatever you want. And that if you want to support us one way or the other, in the corner here, consolacables.be. They provide us with all the cables and the hardware and the power supplies that we need here. So that's all for the Amiga 64, also for, you know, gaming consoles. So your Mega Drives and your Nintendos, they really support us in everything. And that's gonna be it for me. I promised more or less 90 minutes. I'm more or less on that mark for people of assembly. Now, the actual assembly will of course happen later in the year, so you still have some months to make your demos and intros and other productions for that. In the meantime, what I am looking forward to assembly wise is that I want my third Boostdrome tape. I am looking forward to the Boostdrome. It's gonna be awesome, and I want a tape, so do keep one for me. I need my collection to be complete, and otherwise for assembly, you know, I can always use an extra one of these to put into our desk here. This is what you get when you win a compo at the assembly. So yeah, for that, this has been you know, the Melon versus Lemons war that wasn't bloody blah Amiga web show. I have been an arrogant bastard. I will see you later online and hopefully really back in person, because we had also, as everybody had to cancel a lot of travel plans. I really hope things will normalize, and until then, I will see you soon. I have to push a specific button here. I'm want to push this one, but that's not gonna happen. So no, because assembly you can't do that. Anyway, that's it. Goodbye, talk to you soon, and take care.